Welcome to the Colourful Creativity Podcast. My name is Caroline and this is episode 15. As you can see, cats were walking around, so I'm in my living room again. And first things first, welcome to everyone watching, new viewers. I hope you like it here and subscribe down below to see you more often. And of course, a very warm welcome to everyone who is a subscribed and returning viewer. Today is Friday, the 18th of March, and it's a bit of a grey, dreary day here. We've had a lot of sun and we thought, well, yay, spring is coming. But it seems that that is all over again already. I think I might have a bit of a shorter episode. I don't have that much to show, I don't have that much to tell, but I thought I'd just hop on and do my regular episode because I do have nice things to show and tell. Just not as much as I had in the past couple of episodes, but that's okay. It was quite a lot what I had to show you then, especially the acquisitions. And now it's getting back to my kind of normal amount, I think. So, first things first, you can find me as Kralaline on Instagram, Ravelry, Facebook, Twitter, Periscope, Pinterest. I think that was it, right? And there's also a Ravelry group for this podcast, which is the Colourful Creativity group. You can find it in the group section on Ravelry by looking for Colourful with C-O-L-O-U. Not just O in the American way, but with a U in the English way. And there we have a lot of chatter going on about the knit along and about the episodes. You can find links to show notes, etc. also there. And you can find them below here in the description box as well. And you can find a link to the Ravelry group also. There's also my Etsy shop, which is kralaline.etsy.com, and you can also go there by colourfulcreativity.com, no, colourfulcreativity.nl, sorry. And I forget, I redirected my own webpage to my Etsy shop every time. I don't mention it, and I just see it every time I edit my video in my the text I put in here below. So I thought, finally saying it now, colourfulcreativity.nl. I think I might be doing a full website there someday, but for now this is good enough, and I don't have time to make another new website and maintain it, because I already have so many websites to do. So I think that was it for housekeeping and just all the things having to be said. So first up are finished objects. And I have some. Remember this. I have knitted a pair of socks in 13 days. So truly sock madness it is. And I have started out with this one. It was here when I showed you the last time, about here. And I did the heel on Saturday. I ripped it out again and I did it again on Sunday because it was too tight and it just didn't feel nice. It still doesn't, I'll admit. Then I did the cuff and the ribbing, and after that I thought, well, let me just try and see how far I'm gonna get with the second sock, because, well, Sock Madness, I explained last time, is a competition. So for the new viewers, Sock Madness is a competition, and yeah, what can I say about it? It's really madness. You have to finish a pair of socks within 2 weeks, and this was round one, where you it's the setup round, so everyone who subscribes gets the pattern. You can join in by just starting to knit, and you knit on the socks for 2 weeks at maximum. And if you finish within 2 weeks, you can go on to the next round. Round two is the first round where you are teamed up. So you get an email after you have been admitted to a team. And you have to write an email to the organizers who will... Oh my words, they flew out. Binks was making weird noises, so I was paying attention to what he was doing. And apparently he was just eating, but with a lot of noise. So, sorry, let's do that again. And I'm gonna try and keep this episode uncut. So, less editing, less time sitting down for me. I am trying to record in one piece this time, so we'll see where we get. So, organizers get an email from you when you finish your two socks. You say finished and a link to the pattern to the project on your Ravelry page. So yeah, I did that, and also saying thank you very much. I really liked it. I am so utterly proud and amazed by myself that I finished a pair of socks in 13 days. I had never expected that. At the beginning I thought I would just make one sock in 2 weeks, because that's my normal speed. But knitting on one sock at a time instead of two socks apparently makes it faster. No clue. This one took me 8 days. The other one took me only 5 days. Probably because I knew what the pattern was like. I added more stitches. This one is 64, this one is 72. This one actually fits. It does. So this one is gonna be off to the frog pond and re-knit into this one for a size. And as you can see, they are fraternal. I will get out this other colored wedge. It was fun doing it, but I think I like it better if they are really fraternal, and this will be the blue petrol color again. Just like I did the first time I knit that heel. And as you can see, because this one is so tight with its 64 stitches, I really, really had to make it longer. It's about an inch longer than the other one. I think it's about 12 rows longer, counting out of the top of my head. And the cuff is very short, only 50 rows and 20 ribbing. That's the minimal length. I thought if I want to make it, I have to do it the shortest. Not very fond of that, but I will keep it that way. And they will be just nice summery socks, not too high. I'm already knitting on another pair of socks that's gonna be way longer on the cuff. So the pattern is a slip stripe spiral pattern by Milena Pijpers. Milena Pay, she's a Dutch person living in Australia, and she designed it for Sock Madness specifically. She was talking about how many projects there were already there. I think there was over 1,000 people who made this pattern, or at least 1,000 projects. People have done multiples within 2 weeks. Madness, I tell you. So, I think I stopped halfway explaining the sock madness thing. Sorry about that. Scatterbrained today. They get you into a team, and every 2 weeks there's a new pattern, and the slowest people, well, they have to be dropped. Only the fastest people can go on. So there are people who can knit a pair of socks in 10 hours, I think. Which is really, really, really crazy. I can't even imagine how they do that. I have heard the Finnish people are really, really, really fast. So, oh well, I just decided I'm not gonna do this anymore. I really enjoyed knitting these, and I also have cursed a lot on it, especially the heel, but it was fun. And I have noticed that I am not a deadline knitter. I got cramped up like this and sitting, I have to finish. And it was so stressful that I thought, no, this is not what I'm gonna do for the next, I think it's 3 months. It's in 6 rounds after the first one, I believe, until June. So I'm very sure I would have made it to round 2-3 maybe. But they're gonna be very intricate lace patterns, beaded socks, which I have never done. And now I can just cheer other people on, and I will get the patterns because I finished a pair of socks anyway, and I can knit them in my own pace and just relax and see what other people are doing with the craziness of knitting socks. So that said, this episode is called Sock Madness, not just because of these socks. I have only knit on socks, I think, in the past 2 weeks. So I will move on to works in progress, because I wanted to have them finished, but while knitting the first round of ribbing, I thought, no, this is not gonna happen. Oh, I forgot to tell you the yarn I used, of course. The yarn I use for this blue one is Filcolana Arvetta, and I don't know the color. I'm sorry, I did not have a ball band anymore. And this colorful yarn is from Buccinette. It's called Volbot Bambino, so it's a soft baby yarn. And I must say, the Arvetta is 80% merino, 20% nylon, and it's really, really soft. I did not enjoy knitting with it that much. Just the feel on my fingers was very nice because it was all very soft, but it split up like mad, and well, just not very happy when that happens. I knit these on 2.5 millimeter higher sharps, and I think that's about all there is to say. So, first work in progress in the kitty bag. The one I really, really... Damn it. Okay, I'll be right back. My little bings. I have my crusticians next to me, and there are balls like this in there. I have a problem with a cat who took my yarn. So, I will put it back there, and hopefully it will stay there. I will show you, because I'm sitting on toy stash. This is his box full of toys, and there are multiple toys still lying on the floor. So let me just say, he's got his own toys. So much for thinking, simple, regular, uncut episode. But I guess I'll just leave it uncut, because this was just too funny. So in my handmade kitty bag, there are my happy socks. And as you can see, they grew quite a bit, even though I knit a full pair of socks since we last saw each other. But I finished those socks on Sunday, so this is what I managed to do this week. Not that much, because there were other things I wanted to work on. And I didn't have that much time to knit this week also. What can I say? There's a fish lips kiss heel in there. This is Opal Surprise yarn. Here's the ball band. Showing you. There you go. Back side, you can see. And well, after knitting those very nice soft merino and baby yarn socks, I must admit, this is Opal is quite sturdy. But that's okay. After a couple rounds, I got used to it again. I am knitting these on Adi Lace or Adi Sock Rockets. See, they do have a bit of a sharper tip, but I'm just very fond of my Hayahaya sharps, and I'm not sure what I will do with these needles after finishing this. Probably just put them in my needle stash if I ever need a needle again. So, what can I say? I wanted to finish it before recording, but I am doing a twisted rib, and I felt my wrist starting to hurt, so I am only at the first row of the ribbing. I'm not sure if you can see that. Just the first one, and I thought it would be nice to finish it with the pink. So I'm going to orange now, and orange and pink will be the orange, pink. That will be the cuff, and the toe is also pink. So I thought if I start with pink, it will be nice to end with pink as well. So I think it's gonna be around 10 to 20 rounds of ribbing. So first one done, many to go. We'll see. I just like a little plain vanilla sock. Even though I must say the pattern on that slip stripe spiral was also very, very nice and easy and just almost mindless to knit. I had a lot of fun doing that. So let me get that aside. Get my next whip. And that's in my Knit and Stitch Bits bag, where my slip stripe spiral was in before. And in here is some colorful magic or sock blank. It's not magic, it's just a sock blank. Here it is in all its glory. It's a double knit sock blank, hand dyed by me, in a very crazy pattern. You can see there's a stripe of dark on the side, and then there's these arrow-shaped, V-shaped colors in rainbow. And I really wanted to see how this is going to knit up. I have seen it somewhere and it kept showing up in my mind. I have to dye that and I have to do that. And I have no clue anymore how it knit up. I just know I thought it was pretty, so I had to try. And I have got some comments of people wanting one, and I will be dyeing more of these, but I have to convince my husband to making more sock blanks first. I actually have already convinced him to do so. I asked him, but he didn't have time yet, and our attic is just a mess, and there's where I keep my knitting machine for it. So, but hey, and on Instagram I posted a photo of the blank with the other, the happy socks, with, oh, I'm so dying to cast on, but I will finish my socks first. Didn't happen. No, you know me. When I think I want to do something, I just gotta do something, and I will just leave the other whip for what it is. So here it is. I knit the toes, and I knit the same toes as I did in the Sock Madness pattern. It's a, what was it called? It's by Kat Bardi, I believe, and something with prints. Not sure anymore, I'm sorry. I'll look it up and I will put it in my project page on Ravelry. I think it's a very pretty toe because it's a nice rounded and not that flat. I'll get the other one to show you what I mean. I like a rounded toe instead of this pointy toe. Or yeah, it's not really pointy, but it's just cut off, and so in comparison, nice and rounded and pointy. So I might be doing that as my usual toe now. And these are obviously two at a time because I unravel my sock blank and it's knit with double thread. So double stranded. and hopefully they will turn out almost the same. I think I am 3 stitches off, and I thought first of it will bug me, but otherwise who will see that? I will. Yes. Will it bug me in the end? Probably not. It's only 3 stitches, and there might be some difference somewhere, because on the back side here there's some spots instead of a nice point. So that's why I'm using this myself as well. It's a learning curve here. Another reason why I'm using it myself is because there's a hole here. Something went wrong with knitting, and he knew it. So I think it's a very interesting how it looks. It's got striping here, and it's moving that stripe all around probably, and it's pooling here. You can see that here as well. These are getting longer on this side. I'm not sure if next time I would do it again like this, or that I would do a contrasting toe. Maybe I would just do a contrasting toe and then start knitting with the sock blank. But yeah, next time let's finish these first. I'm really curious on how the foot will look, and I'm still at the first colors. Just added a little bit of yellow. Hey, see, this is how it looks at the beginning. It's just a red, pink and red V shape, so with a little bit of yellow, and I'm very curious if I get here what will happen, how that will look on the sock. But we'll see. I might finish the other socks first. I might just knit on this because it's plain vanilla pattern, and I just wanted the yarn and the colors to speak for itself. I'm knitting these on higher sharps, 2.5 millimeters, if I didn't tell you yet. Not sure. And yeah, it is the plan to dye more of these and put them in the shop. So, socks, more socks. So that was it for the socks I have been working on. I have been thinking how many socks are on the needles, and I will have to admit there are probably 3 more pairs on the needles in any stage. I think the 2 mini needle tester socks you saw, I will have to pick them up again to be able to finish them before the 9th of April. I have to knit on those. And there are my This Way That Way socks I started on Christmas Eve, which I just ignored because I wanted to do other socks. And there are just tiny toes of a Zauberball cast on, which I did with the Happy Socks together on my ambitious plan with 4 socks at a time, which didn't work out very well. So yeah, 5 pairs of socks on the needles, I think. And actually needing to frog that sock madness sock. So I call it a finished object, but it's actually only a half finished object. So yeah, well, 6 pairs of socks, but I lent my needle to someone else, my Hayahaya sharp, which I had. So I don't have any needles left for now. So next work in progress. In my beautiful creation by Kaz bag is, of course, my cardigan. And actually, I don't think I have seen this in 2 weeks. So I'm unpacking this and looking for my stitch progress keeper just to find it. Yeah, exactly where I thought it would be. There. That is how much I knit. 1 row. So you can tell what was more important. The sock madness socks. No, it's still here. In this stage. Just the sleeves have been set aside, and I've been knitting here at the underarm. You can see how much I have done. I think I have to do 12 rows and then I have to do something else, but I'm not sure what it was. Might be a decrease, might be an increase. I'll see. I'm knitting this in my own hand-dyed yarn. It's this merino and stellina yarn, which was a colorful experiment. And it's a bit of a mess because the balls I'm using are falling apart. I am knitting this on Haya Haya Sharp interchangeables for my nice set, and they are 3.25 millimeters. Here you can see a very nice sharp tip, which I really, really love. And need, because I'm a tight knitter, so I have to get my needle in there. So the pattern is the Peacock Eyes Cardigan by Justyna Larkowska. You can see, I hope. And let me see. Working stock in a stitch, 12 rows, waist shaping. So I have to decrease. And I have to do a decrease and then another increase. So, and after that it's ribbing. I have no clue how long this is going to be. I might do it just like the pattern says and make it a beautiful short, maybe waist shaped cardigan, which I can wear on top of dresses, but I'm not sure about that yet. I'm only saying that I will make it shorter because I will be finished earlier because I'm not really enjoying it. But I think after knitting so many socks, I might enjoy a bit longer rows again. So I was talking to Britta from Wolgoed this morning, and she said, I really don't like knitting sleeves. And I said, I think I would love knitting sleeves because I hate those endless long rows of just knitting and purling. And we joked about it. I said, well, I'll give you the cardigan, I'll do the sleeves then. So maybe that might be a very nice idea if you live close together, that one knits half of it and the other one knits the other half, and then you switch so you can both wear a cardigan that's half made by you and half made by someone else. Would be a nice idea. So of course I'm knitting that cardigan because of the Colorful Creativity garment knit along that's going on, and I think this will be the last episode that I will be talking about it, because the next one probably will be in April, which means that I will be announcing the winners in the next episode. So if you want to join in, go ahead and put your finished object in the finished objects thread. No chatter there, so please post your finished object in the chatter thread as well, so we can cheer on and applaud you on your work. So would be nice if you do that. I think we are about 10 or 12 entries in, so it's really going well. And the prizes that we have are patterns by Regina from the Herbs About Regina podcast, a project bag by her as well, project bag by me, yarn dyed by me, stitch markers also from the Colorful Creativity collection. So there's quite a few prizes and not that many entries, so you have a very big chance of winning. So go ahead if you want to join in. Do I have anything else to say about a knit along? I don't think so. I am joining other knit alongs though, myself. These crazy rainbow socks, I'm calling them crazy colored or crazy rainbow socks probably, are for the Crazy Color Knit Along by the Happy Knitting Podcast. Julia is hosting that, and I thought crazy color I really can't seem to get any more crazy color like this, because there's kind of neon-y pink and yellow in there, and also this aqua. They are all so bright and crazy colored. I thought that is very, very fitting for that knit along. And talking about knit alongs, I'm also joining in on the knit along of the General Waste Knits podcast by Humbug Watson, or Julia. And she is hosting the Spring Clean knit along, which is also very nice, and it starts at the 20th of March, so coming Sunday, probably when this episode goes up. And yeah, that's just old projects that are over 3 months old in your WIP pile and you want to finish. And I am going to work on my exploration station again. So after this week, I hope to finish my heavy socks and I will knit on my cardigan again. Those are my two goals. Probably do some mindless knitting on my crazy colored socks as well. But that will be it. Probably some knitting on my design project also. Maybe digging up my mini needle test sock. But that will be all in due time. So let me check my show notes. Oh, I scared the kitty. I have to give her some attention. Ooh. They're both next to me, not really willing to come in the screen because we have a very nice warm heating here for them. And next is spinning. And I wanted to show you in my beautiful mess here, there is a ball rolling. This. I showed you my hand spinner, which was a bit too heavy. That was this one, which my father-in-law made. And this yarn is the yarn I got from my mini Turkish spindle. I wound it off, and indeed, I had just tightened it too hard, and it is again now. Because if I don't do that, this will turn, and this will not turn. So it's a bit of a weird construction. I have no clue. Oh yeah, it moves. It's not too tight this time. So that's good. But I wound it off and I left it on here because I thought it looks pretty like this, and I have no clue how I want to apply it and what I'm gonna do with it. So this actually is not even my spin whip. I wanted to try and teach my darling husband how to spin some yarn. I can tell you that was not a success. He hated it, but I think he hated the mini Turkish spindle because he just couldn't get the hang of it, and it might just not be the best thing to start with, which I thought after that. See, these are pieces of fiber he spun up and then he pulled a bit too hard, or he let it twist the other way around so the twist was gone again, and all these pieces of fiber are just snapped. So, oh well, I'll give him a different spindle next time and see if he likes it that way. And while he was doing that, I was using this one, my 3D printed rainbow package spindle by New Age Spinning. And also using rainbow yarn. I'm not sure if you can see that very well. I am trying to keep them a bit together. And I have prepped the fiber this time instead of using the whole roving part. I just split them up in smaller parts and also got half of one strip to do, so it would be a little bit better together. It still has a beautiful barber pole in there. I hope you can see it like this. Like some orange with yellow, but also some purple with yellow. And the blue with some yellowish and purple. But I like it, and I have no clue what this is gonna be, but it's just a technique that I want to learn now. My other spinning is on this one. My father-in-law made me another one, and another one. I think I have four, maybe five even now, but they are getting better and better. I still have to get the handle detached and put a bead on here so it's pretty, but for now this is good enough. Oh yeah, and I have to get some sandpaper to fix this side, because this one is just a little bit rough and picks up the fiber. And I'm spinning a mini bed of Dutch Wool Diva. As you can see, I'm spinning a bit thicker because I wanted to try that. And it's actually a lot of fun. I don't know if you have ever seen it, how it works. So I will pull a little bit out. Here you can see I want to spin a bit thicker, so. You just twist it and then you wind it on again. And then you do the next piece and on and on and on. So it's really nice and easy, and I guess my husband would really be capable of doing this, but he said he didn't like it. He thought this was just no fun at all. Oh well, he has his nerd stuff. Which also makes me happy, because that means I have an evening off where I can just go to see a friend and knit with her, which I did last night, which was a lot of fun. And I heard some very interesting things there. And I'm not gonna share the names, but she has a nice plan to start podcasting as well. And she has that plan together with someone else who's also a viewer of this podcast. And they chose to make a pact. And if you think what I'm doing, I'm putting my ball together with its ball band again. And well, yeah, I really, really hope they do so, because I think they will be very interesting podcasters. And I'm looking forward to seeing them. So that's that for spinning. So next up is acquisitions. And you saw the first one. And also another one. Oh, I've got fluff all around here from spinning. It's fluff. Go away. Let go. See? It's not very nice. Oh, put that away. Where it belongs, which is up there. So I have these. You can see nice balls and one bundle. These are my mother's minis. I really don't think they are mini. I think they are at least 20 grams. And these three are Trekking XXL by Zitron. This is the same yarn base I use for my dyeing, which is really nice. My mom loved this, so I'm very curious how she will love my hand dyed, because I don't think she ever knit on my hand dyed yarn before. But that will change probably very soon, because it will be my mom's birthday Sunday. We're celebrating tomorrow because she has other plans on her birthday. And well, I'll show you that at the shop update talk. There was also this one, and this is a yarn I de-stashed. It is a Invicta Glamour, and it's showing up very, very weird now. So I'll keep it here. It's probably just as red as the door behind me. And yeah, because of the glitter, it was not very nice of a nip, she said. It was a bit, the metal, it just, the glitter is always a metal strand in it, and you feel that. And I also got this one. You know it when your mom's a serial knitter. She knits socks really, really quickly. And probably not in in 10 hours, but still, I think she does a pair a week if she wants to. And she's been knitting a lot of socks lately because she didn't want to go on with her cardigan. I see where that comes from now. Just knit on socks and ignore the cardigan. So, oh well. I like it because I always get her leftovers and I can use that for my blanket and for giveaways and for swaps. So I'm gonna use them also on my own scrap yarn socks because I like that. I could easily make a pair of scrap yarn socks themed by all the yarns my mom gave me. So that will be fun, I think. But they will just go in my big bag of minis and leftovers, and I will see. I think this is a Langyarns Magic Degradé yarn. I haven't even seen her socks with it, so very curious about that. Let's put that aside on that side, so they won't be dropping. So that was the first acquisition. Another acquisition is something you probably haven't seen ever from me. This is handspun yarn. And there's a big bit of a story behind it, and I'm not sure if I can share it here. Because this is not for me. I swapped this with someone, and I'm not sure if I can tell her name, so I will not do that. And she did this for me, and I dyed up some yarn for her, and that was really a lot of fun to do. So I hope to make someone else very happy with this. This is a Dutch breed of sheep. I think it's Texelaar. It's from the Isle of Texel. And I think that's all I'm gonna say about it, because I'm not sure if the person who's getting this is watching the podcast, and I will write it all down for her. So let's put it aside. Next things I can talk about. I will get this out of the little bag to show you. I got this. You see that little ring? I might be better like this. It is a kitty stitch marker. It's a ring, snag-free, with ears. And I saw these, and I just had to have them. They come in little baggies of 10. And yeah, well, I really, really love them. They come all the way from Australia. And let me see. GradientYarnAustralia.com. Yeah, that was it. I was a bit distracted by Gradient NZ on Facebook. That would mean New Zealand and not Australia. But here's the card. And yeah, what can I say? It was here rather quickly. I think within 2 weeks, really the maximum. Maybe it was even within 7 days. And yeah, they just look lovely. I love gold. I'm more a gold person than a silver person, so and I love cats. So what can you do? You just have to order. So I'm gonna have fun with those in my knitwear and working on it. And the next acquisition came an hour after recording the previous one. As usual. Business as usual. This is a bag full of hedgehog fibers, and it's called an itsy bitsy fiber, and it's approximately 250 grams of yarns, and it's a variety of wool, silk, camel, alpaca, flex, and sparkle, and more. And yeah, I have no clue what it is. I can't feel the yarn like that yet. I do think it's quite sturdy. I also am very curious about what this is. It looks like acrylic, but maybe that's just the sparkle and you have to blend it with something. If someone else got this and does have a clue what it is, because there's three fluffs of that stuff in there. Maybe it is something, it smells like yarn, but I'm not quite sure what it is. And well, there's a lot of stuff in there, and also very pretty stuff, like this color, this teal seafoam color, which I really love. And then here, oh, this feels weird. Could this be camel, maybe? I'm not sure, but this is really pretty as well, nice and dark. Actually, wouldn't be the first thing I would pick, but I really love the colors together, so some kind of midnight dreamy color. Or like a very good glass of wine. Or maybe some very pretty nail color, which matches perfectly. So might just be my color. So I have no clue what it all is, and I'm very curious if someone does. And I would love to hear from you if you do. I am thinking of just looking at these at the moment, not using it. I saw this come online and I was already in bed, and I even ordered from my bed with my tablet, and I have to have that. So I was a very naughty girl that moment. I just had to have it. And I might wait for using this until I have a blending board, so I can do that sparkly stuff or that weird stuff with the other stuff. I have no clue yet what I'm gonna do with it. We'll see. Maybe just practice yarn for spindle spinning. I'm not sure. So on to my final thing. Oh, you kitties, you get scared a lot today. My last, but definitely not the least, I just saved the best for last, is my FiberShare. And FiberShare is a big swap going world round. I think there was over 650 participants, and you get matched up with someone in the same group. So if you want something to knit, you get matched up with someone who knits and also wants knit stuff. Same goes for someone who likes spinning and etc., crochet, weaving. There are different options. And well, I got a beautiful bag. That's the first one. Maker's gonna make. And I got this from Nina from the US, and I was so surprised because she said she had shipped it, and I thought, oh well, that's gonna take a while. It was here in 4 days, people. 4 days. She did not pay extra, she did not pay a hell of a lot of money for it, and still it was here in 4 days. I was just over the moon happy with that. So I will start unpacking this bag, and she said she sent me a note with everything explained in here. So this bag she got from doing a what do you call it? Oh, let me find the notes. I have the notes in here. Yes, here it is. What was it called? Maker's gonna make project bag. Oh yes, a Kickstarter campaign. That was the word I was looking for. So she wrote it all down, everything in its own color, which is really, really awesome. And a very, very nice note with it. And Yeah. So with a Kickstarter from Garter here, I believe. Part of their Kickstarter. Oh no, it's what probably Maker's gonna make Kickstarter campaign. So the Garter here, what I had in mind. Gather here, sorry, not Garter. Is her local yarn store, and she got me a tape measure from that, which I really love because I broke my tape measure not too long ago. And there's a lot of stuff in here, so I will just start unpacking. This beautiful squishy skein of yarn is Quince and Co. Lark in the colorway Cypress 127, I think. And this is 100% American wool, 50 grams, 134 yards or 123 meters. And I love this color. It reminds me actually of Christmas, like that really nice warm green. So I'm not sure what it's gonna be, but it's a nice thick yarn for a US size 6 or US size 8 needles. I'm not sure how much that is, but I think it's a 4 or 5 millimeter. So that is just lovely. And I also got this, which is a beautiful skein of Manos del Uruguay silk blend. Here's the card, and it's in magenta. And this is a 70% extra fine merino with 30% silk. And I know the yarn because I knit my my first Purpurium cardigan with it, which is really, really lovely. And this is also for a US size 6. This is a 4.25 millimeter. So yeah, probably 4 to 5 millimeter needles for this one and this one. And I have a lot of fingering yarn in my stash, and these are all a bit thicker. All the yarns in the bag. No, not all. Two not. But I really like that because that's really out of my comfort zone, which makes it very nice. So then there's this, and it's Abuelita yarns, thick and thin, which is a 100% merino. And also for US needle size 8 to 10, so that will probably be a 5 to 6 millimeter. And here you can see colors are a bit washed out, I might say, but thick and thin it really is. So very curious. She said I could easily make a pair of wrist warmers with it. So I'll just see what this is gonna be. My lap is filling up. There's also this. And this is a bit of Donegal Chunky Tweed by Debbie Bliss. In a beautiful purple color. And it's really, really chunky, as you can see. And this is 100% wool from Ireland. I love Ireland. For those who know me a bit, I really want to go there, especially to Cork and surroundings. I have been traveling there with my husband for 19 days when we were students, and not married yet, but we had really the best time ever. And especially Cork and down there. Yeah, it was just beautiful. I love Ireland and I would so, so love to go back. And we might even this year, next year. Going there is really the biggest on my wish list for vacation, next to Denmark, which we really loved last year. So apparently I'm someone who would like to return to places instead of going to new places. So next one on the list is this. And this is Malabrigo worsted, as you can see there, which is also a 100% merino yarn and really, really soft. And this color is a really pretty dark green and blue, olive green in there, jeans blue, and I really really love that. And it might become a hat for me. Maybe I would do an antler hat, or I might do something with a cable pattern hat, because I think it would really be nice for me. And then, almost empty now, there were these beautiful Madeline Tosh unicorn tables. Madeline Tosh, here you can see the card. A unicorn tail in cathedral, that's this purple one, which is very very pretty. And this is glass bottom boat, which is of course also very pretty. So glass bottom boat, so that means the sea colors of the sea. Well, glass is also very good for me, of course, and since I'm a scuba diver, I love the sea and the colors of the sea, so that name is just perfect for me. It's 100% superwash merino, and this is for smaller needles, US size 1 to 2 or 2.25 to 2.75, which will probably end up as a 2.5 millimeter for me. And I'm not sure what I will do with this yet, of course, but we'll see. Some things just have to mature before they get used. And I'm putting this back so I can reach to the last bit of the package, because I got some awesome notebook. This is just beautiful also on the inside with the golden print here, and I really really love it. So on the front there's this notebook belongs to, with also a very pretty golden print. And apparently, even if I don't have that much to tell you, I get to an hour. So there was also this beautiful artwork, because this is what Nina does. Nina is an artist, and she draws and paints, and I think this is just so beautiful. I made a photo of it and I saw totally different things, and I keep turning it around. I know she autographed it here, but also when you turn it around you see other things in it, and I really like that. So, and then there was this notebook, which was a Japanese notebook, I think. I will look it up in her notebooks. The grid one is from Muji in New York City. So I have a notebook from New York City, which is awesome, because I am not sure if I will ever go to New York. I'm not that much of a flying person. I don't like to go in airplanes, and well, let me just say, New York is quite a bit of a long airplane ride, flight, whatever. So I'm not looking forward to that. My maximum is about 4 hours, and I think New York is 7 or 8, maybe even 10. So not gonna happen that fast, I guess. So, and this notebook is a grid notebook with dots in it, so you can make it a bullet journal, which this one will be. And I am keeping the artwork in here because I like to see it. So that was my fiber share, and I'm really really enthusiastic, and I really really loved it. It was so much fun unpacking this, and I am so grateful, because it was all very very pretty in here. I am still making my package for my partner, so if you are watching, then yes, I am working on it, and yes, it is still coming, and I am hoping to be able to ship it this week. I am almost there. Almost. So, that was it for the acquisitions, and I'm looking at my notes, and I am at my shop update, which isn't there. there's only things coming out of the shop. Oh, there's more fiber on here. Damn it. Sorry. Don't want to be offensive, but I don't want fluff on my beautiful skein. As I told you, I dyed some yarn for a swap with that handspun yarn, and I had to dye up a purple skein, and I will have to see in the editing mode if this shows a true color. For me it turns a blue, but it really is purple, so lots more red in it. And the swap yarn is already gone. It was a normal sock yarn, but I thought I might just add a tweed yarn to that dye pot. It's just a semi-solid one, and after finishing it I thought, this might be the perfect gift for my mother for her birthday. So this is not going into the shop, but it's going to my mother, and I will see if I cake it up or just give it to her like this. But she loves knitting socks, as you saw with all the balls I got, all the leftovers. And I'm very curious what she thinks of this yarn, the tweed yarn, but also this is also trekking tweed, so it's the same brand as she knit with. And I'm curious if there's a difference between this and the hand dyed and the commercial dyed. So we'll see what happens. And yeah, in the end I probably will get a leftover bag, but hey, we'll see. Maybe she will knit them knee length and just finish it all. I don't think so, because she starts at the cuff and she has to go to the toe, so she always keeps it a bit the same, so she knows how much yarn she will be have left. And the other thing I wanted to tell you is that I put in my first Haya Haya order. Yay! So next time I will be having a lot of things to show you, probably, because I think I have 80 items in that box. Oh! Come here! Someone wants attention. Or his food's all gone. That's probably more possible. Oh well, he'll have to wait a little bit. I'm almost finished, so he'll get his attention and his food. The Haya Haya order is done. I have ordered a lot of needles, sharps, bamboo and steel in different sizes and lengths, and also some sets of interchangeable needles, kitty snips, puppy snips, octopus snips, sleepy kitty snips, just a set of all the kinds of snips there are. So the little scissors that you can take everywhere you go. Panda stoppers, yes, I have ordered those as well. And some other things that will be pretty when I show it to you on the next podcast. And also there were some new colors of the Katona cotton yarn I have for my workshops. And since I had some colors out of stock after the last Mindful Crochet workshop this week, I thought, let me order all the new colors as well. And they will be coming in next week also, so I will have them in time for the beginner crochet workshop I will be hopefully teaching next week. And also for the next craft night, which is the 5th of April. And for the next for the upcoming craft high tea. So I will be bringing all the yarn that I have to those events. And I really hope you like it, that I bring it and you want to buy some. So yes, we have still, I think, 3 or 4 places left for the craft high tea. If you want to join in, be quick. The goodie bags are almost everything is in. I'm waiting for a few packages also. I am not showing you those packages because I want to keep it a surprise to everyone who's coming. And won't be fun if you know what's in there. I have done some teasers. Binks is sniffing out my acquisitions there. And on my... You're not eating the fluff. No. He just likes to eat the fluff. So he was sniffing my spindle. That's gonna go there. And what was I saying? I have done some teasers, of course, about Goodie Bag online on Instagram and on Facebook and on Twitter, but I'm not gonna show you everything because if I do that, that's just no fun for everyone who's coming. There will be a lot of goodies in there. I think we are over 20, maybe even 25 goodies. And it's so much fun making those bags. Just organizing it all. And I want to thank all of the participants for the sponsors for the goodie bag, of course. You did have a little bit of fluff in your mouth. Yeah. So hopefully that'll teach him. He eats all the fluff that's lying around. I should call him vacuum cleaner instead of Binks. So, well, Laia is walking under me and under my chair. Not sure what she's doing, but that's okay. I think this is it for today. And we're already over an hour, so I'll leave it at that. I think I have some cute cat clips on the camera. And I will put them in the end of this episode. Anything I wanted to say? No, I think that was it. So, have a great day and see you back in 2 weeks. Bye bye!